Hello, my name is Mike, and today I want to show you how to connect a front-end form to your advanced custom fields with no need to code. When I say advanced custom fields, I'm referring to the ACF plugin. And if you're using ACF, you're probably a developer that's comfortable coding. But we're about to save you a lot of time. Let's get started. First, in your Formidable add-ons, activate the Advanced Custom Fields add-on. Next, I'm going to create a group field in ACF. If you already have your fields created, feel free to skip ahead to making a front-end form. Now, for this website, I'm going to be creating new blog posts for my birdwatching site. I want to collect users' names, the day they went birdwatching, the time they went birdwatching, the type of birds they saw, and how many of each, and collect any additional comments. For each field I'm making, I'm sure to use the correct field type, such as a date field and a time field, and not just standard text fields for each. I'm making sure to use a repeater field for the type of and number of birds section, since they could see multiple types of birds in each session. Inside that repeater, I'll choose a dropdown, which is called a select type field in ACF. I'll add the various birds they would be expected to see as choices, and then I'll add a number field. After I add a text area field to collect additional comments, I'll add a title to this new field group. I'll call it Birdwatching. I'll save my work, and we're ready to create our form. So I'll create a new form, and I'll also call it Birdwatching. Now here I need to add the fields that will match to my ACF fields. I'm going to add an extra one for post titles, but you might not need to do that if you're matching to a previously made field group in ACF. Because ACF doesn't have a name field type, our name field will be a text field. I'll add a date field and a time field as well, so we can keep track of exactly when these birds were spotted. For the actual birds found, we'll put in a dropdown field and a number field. We'll also need to put these fields inside of a repeater field so it will function like the ACF group. I should make sure I name my repeater field so the form doesn't just say repeater in it. I'll add a paragraph field for additional comments. Oh, and I need to fill out my dropdown options for the birds. I'll make sure I do that too. Okay, perfect, we have our form. I'll update to save it. Now let's go to settings. Under actions and notifications, I'll choose create post. For post title, I'll choose my extra text field that I added at the beginning of my form. But the cool stuff happens once you hit this toggle. Map form fields to advanced custom fields. I'll choose my birdwatching field group and then match my formidable fields to my advanced custom fields. Notice that my choices are limited to the type of field that matches. I only have one option for date and time. The same goes for my birdwatching repeater field. My subfields are automatically put in on the formidable side, but I'll need to match them to the correct subfields in my ACF group. And then finally, my additional comments to additional comments. And that's it. That's all you need to do to create a front-end form connected to ACF, no code needed. This was a pretty highly requested feature, so let us know what you're going to use it for. Subscribe for more form building and WordPress tips, and I'll see you next time.